High School, Dulabari, Nepal, in collaboration with Sunbeam School of Varuna, India, is presenting a talk show. At least 8 hours of sleep a day, which will be presented by Gracie Rai. Importance of respect and valuing. Importance of keeping yourself active. Importance of social interaction with others. Importance of picking up a new skill or hobby. Importance of getting a mental workout. Importance of doing something for others. Importance of learning to manage stress. Importance of positive thinking and its implementation. Importance of knowing laughter is the best medicine. I'm sure the talks presented by these beautiful people, good looking people, beautiful means beautiful from the heart, people will really encourage everyone that's listening to have a positive thought, a positive aspect towards what's being said, and I'm sure we'll follow whatever is said. They have researched, they have done a lot of research to find out about the management of different aspects. So I'd like to present Gracie Rai for her topic.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to ask you a question. How many hours do you sleep? Right, I'm pretty sure that most of you prefer watching TV shows or playing games than sleeping. People who can get by on 4 hours of sleep most of the time brag about the injuries and strength, but recent scientific study shows that lack of sleep can cause many significant changes in the body and increase risk for serious health concerns such as obesity, heart disease, and even early death. There is a finding, a 17 article shows that those people who were sleeping less than 5 hours or 7 hours were more likely to experience a premature death. Research shows that consistently getting 8 hours of sleep is beneficial for an adult. Any lesser increase can cause increase in serious health concerns such as diabetes mellitus, heart disease, and even early death. Sleep is a necessary human function. It allows our brain to recharge and our bodies to rest. When you sleep, your brain signals your body to release hormones and compounds that help decrease risk for health conditions, retain your memory, maintain your immune function, and manage your hunger levels. What happens if you don't sleep? When you do not get enough sleep, our bodies do not get full benefits of sleep, such as muscle repair and memory consolidation. Not getting enough sleep can weaken our immune system, cause thinking issues, mental stress, and lead to weight gain. When you do not get enough sleep, you may also increase your risk for certain cancers, heart disease, and even car accidents. Lack of sleep increases disease risk. You forget stuff, you can't think properly, and your heart suffers. Sleep helps reduce stress. High stress levels can make sleeping more difficult. They can even lead to sleep disorders. At the same time, getting a good night's sleep can help the effects of stress, and when you are tired, you are less patient and easily agitated, which can increase stress. When your body does not get enough sleep, it can react by producing an elevated level of hormones, stress hormones, which are a natural result of today's faster-paced lifestyle. So deep and regular sleep can help prevent this. Reasons why good sleep is important. Good sleep can improve your concentration and productivity. It can improve your memory. It can improve your immune function. It puts you in a better mood. Good sleep improves your athletic performance. It makes you smarter. It is a painkiller. Adequate sleep is a key part of a healthy lifestyle. Getting quality sleep is one of the best things you can do to reduce stress. Thank you.
Thank you, Gracie. Now, another good quality we need is showing respect. Miss Navina Prasai here to present her views on the importance of respect.
Thank you, ma'am. Today's my topic is, what do you mean by respect? According to me, respect is a way of treating or behaving to a person for what they are and how they can be. People show respect in different ways, by treating them politely or kindly. Being respected by an important person teaches us how to be good toward the other. It can be in different ways. According to me, it also the way of respecting the people or accepting the people how they are without judging them, how they can be or what they can do in future. How do we show respect? There are different ways to show respect. It can be in different situation or different level. First of all, thank people for their assessment in different kind of the work. They can be in their studies or the physical work, or can be in mental work too. Be sincere. You can be sincere toward everyone, toward your parents, toward your teacher, toward your friends. It helps you to be a respectful person in your life. Do what you say you do. You will say you do. Stick toward your word. Try to implement the word in your life too. Just don't say it. Express it too. Offer your assessment. Everyone can't be perfect in their lives. They do need some assistance by people. They can be in your studies, they can be in physical work too. While offering people respect, always respect their abilities, what they have done in your life, what they have put an effect in your life. Don't just compliment them with disgraceful words. Why is respect so important? Yes, why is so important? As I have already said before that, respect is the word which is used when people accept people for who they are, without judging them, without complimenting them. It helps us to feel safe and carefree for who we are. It also helps a good relationship between every people in this world. You can build nowadays in teenager, this is the most important thing, respect. Because nowadays the relation between person in teenagers are being disturbed due to the respect. It's better to show the respect in simple way without showing the aggressiveness or other things. Benefit of respect. Benefit create of your environment. It helps to be who you are. It helps us people to be careful towards the things. It helps us to reduce our stress, because we will be carefree among the things we have done. Respect also improves the knowledge sharing. It helps us to share our knowledge we have without thinking of others. Respect also boosts our bottom line. It explains that it helps us to make a positive thinking toward the people. It helps to be a good people in your lives, which make us a better person than we are before. Thank you. At last, I want to tell that, give respect and you will get respect. Thank you.
Give respect and you'll get respect. And I'm sure this applies to all of us. What is the importance of keeping yourself active? Will be explained to us by Sakuntala Thapa.
Good morning, everyone. Today's my topic is importance of keeping yourself active. Firstly, I would like to say that we all people know how to keep ourselves active, isn't it?
Yes.
There are many ways to keep ourselves active. We can involve ourselves in physical activities like by getting regular exercise. Would you involve in any activities that you enjoy to do?
Yes.
By consuming healthy diet. Would you like to eat the junk food that you like?
Yes.
But we should not. Yes, ma'am. By avoiding consumption of tobacco and other unnecessary products. Today in this modern age, mostly boys are consuming the tobacco and other unnecessary products which are very harmful for our health. And secondly, there are many benefits that we get from our physical activities which will be very helpful for us. And the point goes like this. It helps to reduce blood pressure and cholesterol level. When we do physical activities, it helps to decrease stress and improve sleep and mental well-being. Prevents serious health problems, helps to keep our bones and muscles strong. With the help of physical activities, these are the most activities that we follow in our day-to-day life. As we all know, physical activities makes our body fit and healthy. What else can I do to stay healthy? Another point. What will you do in your day-to-day life to stay healthy? According to me, I always get involved in regular exercise. I avoid eating junk food, consuming balanced diet and safe drinking water. I reduce hypertension. I involve myself in active work like dancing, sports, walking and other activities that I enjoy to do. In conclusion, I would like to suggest all of you to involve yourself in active work to remain healthy, happy and fit and fine in your day-to-day life. Thank you.
Today I'm here for the presentation of on the topic of importance of picking new skill and hobbies for reducing mental stress. And first, I want to tell what are hobbies. Hobbies are any activities done in leisure to pass time for the pleasure and relaxation of nature, which reduces the mental stress. And the second one is photography. Photography also reduces the mental stress, that enriches your passion and helps to fulfill your all desires. And the another one that boosts your skill and enriches to reduce the mental stress is yoga. Yoga also helps to decrease your mental stress, that empowers your spirit outside the world. And similarly, another one is reading and writing. Reading and writing are also the important for the student to reduce the mental tension. It changes your mind frame and also boosts your skill to the outside world. And another one is playing musical instrument. It relaxes our mind in a free time and also boosts your skill and makes us active in various curriculum activities. Now I want to tell why to pick up new hobbies and skills. Having a hobby is just not a fun. It is also helpful for the mental health. It is important in such a way to learn and broaden our skill and perspectives. Similarly, there are various importance of hobbies to reduce the mental stress. And hobbies are great stress reliever. It helps to relieve the various stress that we do in whole day. Give you change of mind frame. That it also offers new challenges and experiences. It helps to give get experiences in various fields and gain knowledge from it. It helps to explore your knowledge to the world and introduce yourself to the world. It improves your career, grows you spiritually, enriches your perspective, and so on. And another one is, do I need a hobby? When people think, wait, do they need a hobby? Yes, of course. Everyone should have one or two hobby. If there is no hobby, then life becomes too burden, and people becomes like the first one is, they feel boredom, they lost their momentum, they have no interest in any activities, they will lose their intellectual and social skill, they will be tired from every walk and finally cause mental tension, which is very dangerous for every human being. And Next one is the main topic of our presentation, that is, can hobbies reduce our mental tension? Yes, hobbies are scientifically proven to improve psychology. Only our routine works mimic our narrow perspectives and also cause the fatigue and long-term mental diseases like stress, depression, skepticism and so on. So to boost such problems, there are the skills that we can do is yoga. Yoga reduces your body's physiological stress response. And the another one is dancing. Dancing also relieves our all stress and helps to express our emotions and stress. Another one is knitting, that reduces our mental as well as physical stress. And writing, that clears our negative thought and brings us in a positive way. Next, similarly, the next is gardening, that distracts you from the outside worries and helps to decrease the mental tension. Thank you.
To you all, we in a stage time on the topic mental pressure. Mental pressure in general term means stress on human mind due to unexpected situation. It arises in each and every day because of different situation, because of different deadline, target, aims and demand to meet. Aspect of mental pressure. There are two aspects of mental pressure. They are positive and negative. Positive aspect, it includes that it helps to motivate us to meet our objectives, targets and perform our tasks confidently under pressure. Negative aspect, it includes that we suffer from a panic situation, that stress, memory problems, uncertain behavioral changes, etc. Some causes of mental pressure are family, society, friends, norms and value, colleague, relation, work, etc. Now going to the main topic, mental workout. Mental workout is the exercise that keeps us free from mental pressure. Mental workout can be the best solution for the maintaining a peaceful mind. A healthy mind can store positive thought. Mentally sound people can create their own path. Some of the exercise including in mental pressure, mental workout are yoga, hiking, dancing, singing, weightlifting, etc. Some of the benefits and importance of mental workout are sharper memory and thinking. If a person mentally free from mental pressure, person can create their innovation, new ideas, knowledge, views for the betterment of life. It means that we believe in ourselves and know that we are a great addition to this world. You have a few weaknesses, but you have a lot of strengths. That's really shape of who you are. Better sleep. Stress-free mind helps us to sleep peacefully. It's compulsory to sleep more than 6 hours a day. More energy. Increase in stress and stable mind increase energy to work on for the betterment of life. Conclusion. Mental workout helps us to get free from depression and anxiety, decrease our stress and tension, increase our self-esteem and confidence. It helps us to increase our memory and help us to be free from any problem and feel more relaxed and have positive about life. Mental workout turned to be a powerful medicine for many common mental health challenges. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to let you know about the importance of helping others. Now let's see. Why doing something for others is important. Doing something for others, whether small or big, is a powerful way to boost your own happiness as well as the others around you. Doing so, you not only make yourself happy, but also the people whom you help. Money is not just a measurement of helping. You can help people by giving your time, skill, ability. It means a lot, or more than financial transaction in some case. Now let's see about the benefits of helping people. Helping others is the key to happiness. As you all know that, when we help people, it certainly helps, makes us happy, and other people also too. If you practice helping people once a week also, it affects our happiness and joy in our life. Helping others builds trust. When you help people, you feel happy, and to whom you help, they also remain happy. There lies a truthness within them to whom you help. Happiness builds network. When you help people, when you certainly help people, you first of all you help for one people, now you go for the second one, then the chain goes on. People start knowing you, they will identify you in every field, in every sector. So it helps to build network. Now next topic is helping others improve society. When you start helping people, other people will be empowered with you, get inspired with you by doing so. They will also start to help people do the same thing as you did, and certainly it helps to improve the society. Helping others gives a sense of purpose. Giving to someone gives a sense of purpose to the individual. The person who volunteers feels their life is worthwhile, and that leads to the sense of satisfaction. So, helping others gives us a sense of purpose. Now, as we know that happiness leads to happiness, and positive mentality is one of the aspects of happiness, and also it helps to build trust, which also helps to lead a positive mentality. We gain respect by helping others. This also affects to maintain a positive mentality. And last of all, improve society. If everyone start helping each other, you will get respected, and thus the society will change. And also makes us happier and healthier too. Giving also connects us to others, creating stronger communities and helping to build a happier society for everyone. It's not just all about money. We can give our time, ideas and energy. By doing so, our mentally always remain healthier and positive. At last, so if you want to feel good, do good. Thank you.
You talked very well on the importance of doing something for others, and I think that's one of the reasons that really helps us lessen the mental stress that we are in. Whenever we try to help out others, we feel good about ourselves, and then everything becomes better. Now, Avina Sai is going to tell us something about the importance of clearing to manage stress.
What is stress? Stress is the normal reaction the body has when changes occur. It can respond to these changes physically, mentally or emotionally. But there is no particular definition of stress that everyone agrees on. It is because what is stressful for one person may be pleasurable or have little effect on others. We all react to stress differently. You know, she is Oprah Winfrey. Oprah Winfrey is an American media executive, actress, talk show host, television producer and philanthropist. She is best known for her talk show, The Oprah Winfrey Show. Oprah Winfrey Show, which was the highest rated television program of its kind in history and ran in national syndication for 25 years. She was the richest African American of the 20th century and North America's first black multi-billionaire. In an interview of 2013, she said that stress nearly caused her to have a nervous breakdown. She said, in the beginning she thought that it was just a kind of sort of spearing and a kind of numbness which was going from one thing to the next thing but later she realized that she realized that if she is not going to calm down, she is going to be in a serious trouble. She is Maureen Killoran. She says that stress is not what happens to us, it's our response to what happens, and response is something we can choose. So stress is nothing but it is just the gap between the expectation and the reality. More the gap, more the stress. So expect nothing and accept everything. Being bullied. If you have a fear of being bullied by someone at school, at workplace or anywhere, it will create stress to your body and mind and hence leads to your mental pressure. Working too hard. For instance, let's take an example of students. Let's imagine if you all are studying in a room continuously for hours and hours without taking a break in between. What will be the consequences of it? We might suffer from anxiety and hence it will lead to mental pressure. Death in family. If there is death of the beloved ones in family, then we might face the situation of stress which further lead to mental pressure. Difficulty in school. In school we might face a lot of problems such as being bullied by seniors, being punished by teachers without committing any mistake, being teased by the juniors or seniors and being discriminated on the basis of height, weight, etc. may influence one under the situation of stress. Busy schedule. If you have busy work schedule from morning to evening and if you need to work continuously for hours and hours without pauses in between, then we feel fatigued doing the work for a long time as we are not able to take rest in order to recreate ourselves and we go under stress. Family problems. Most of the parents nowadays think that the children taking science are far more talented than the student of other faculties. It is because the children are forced to take science despite of their willingness and ability, which compel them to bring the situation of stress among them. Other family problems include regular quarrel and argument between parents, financial problem, etc. Is stress always bad? For instance, stress can help you meet daily challenges, motivates you to reach your goals. In fact, stress can help you accomplish tasks more efficiently. It can even boost memory. But too much stress can be detrimental. Emotional stress that stays around for weeks, months, can weaken the immune system and can cause high blood pressure, fatigue, depression, anxiety and even heart diseases. So the solution for it can be stress management. What is stress management? Stress management is a wide spectrum of techniques and psychotherapies aimed at controlling a person's level of stress, especially chronic stress, usually for the purpose of and for the motive of improving everyday functioning. Stress management is the process of making changes to your life if you are in a constant stressful situation, preventing stress by practicing self-care and relaxation and managing your response to stressful situation when do occur. Keep a positive attitude. In general, positive attitude means being optimistic about situations, interactions and yourself. While having a positive attitude doesn't necessarily make you feel less stressed, but also helps to equip you with the tools that need to cope up with the stress in a healthier way. Accept that there are events that you can't control. Some of the events such as natural disasters, accidents are not upon our control, but if you go on making the strategies in order to beat such events, it is nothing but waste of time and energy of an individual into the wrong place. And ultimately those strategies backfire and create even more stress. So one must accept the brutal truth that every events are not under our control. Be assertive instead of aggressive. We should even try to deal with the worst situation with positive and confident personality. Instead of being aggressive and losing control upon our emotions, We should keep calm and try and assert our feelings, opinions and beliefs instead of becoming angry, defensive or passive. Learn and practice relaxation techniques. We should try to learn and practice relaxation techniques such as meditation, yoga, etc. We should give at least 10 minutes of time to perform such kinds of activities in order to keep our body and mind calm and healthy. Performance of those activities in the morning time can be more effective. Importance of stress management. Improvement in overall health condition. If you are able to manage our stress, we will not only be physically fit but also mentally and emotionally sound and healthy. We will be happy and healthy individual, and thus through stress management there will be overall improvement in the health condition. Helps eliminate unnecessary energy drain. With the management of stress, we can be able to remain calm and positive even in worst situation, which saves our energy. So through the stress management, we are able to avoid energy drain by utilizing our energy at the right work. Maintain stored resiliency. With the stress management, we have maintained stored resiliency. Resiliency is the ability to adapt with the situation when things doesn't go as per plan. Resilient people don't dwell with the failure, but they acknowledge the situation, learn from the mistakes and then move forward. According to Ensei, it's not the stress that kills us, it's our reaction to it. So give your stress wings and let them fly away. And lastly, if you can't handle your stress, you won't manage success. Thank you.
We'll go for another topic which says the importance of positive thinking and its implementation. Sanjog Limbu.
Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm here to say something about the topic mental pressure. First of all, I would like to say something about mental pressure. What is mental pressure? Mental pressure is a state of mental tension, something that can cause strong feelings of worries or anxiety. Physical forces or pressure. What are the causes of mental pressure?
Yeah, there are many causes of mental pressure, as you know.
It's shown here in the diagram. When you get the homework, you have the mental pressure. When you have the losses in the business, you have the mental pressure. And just some minutes ago, when you tell us the result, you have the mental pressure. In the common thing, when you play games, yeah, battery low, oh, mental pressure. Mental pressure. So, what to do to reduce that mental pressure? It's a very big burden in our life, yeah. Very big, look there. That the man is very burden. So, it's like to reduce the mental pressure. And there are different ways, activities to do to reduce the mental pressure. And one of them is positive thinking. Yeah. So what is positive thinking? Positive thinking is a mental and emotional attitude that focuses on the bright side of life and expects positive results. Importance of positive thinking and its implementation. There are many importance of positive thinking. Yeah, I am having the mental pressure. Too much pressure in my mind, yeah, but I am thinking positive because I am thinking. Yes, I am thinking. Optimistic, that means hoping for good. Everything you hope for good. Imaginative, you might imagine very, very what good things like. Something good. And enterprising, motivated in your work, happy, encouraged, etc. Encouraged. How many of you have encouraged yourself by thinking a positive? Yeah, you might. I think you have encouraged yourself that I will be pass, but the result was fail. Yeah, that might be the good encouragement. It might not finish your stress, mental tension, but it can reduce your mental pressure. That was your
strong.
You can be strong by thinking of mental things, but positive things in your mind. Yeah, I think them the like Hulk, but I'm not. But it makes me strong to feel like a Hulk, and I can do some box, not like Hulk. Little mind. Yeah, it the positive thinking makes you determined to do something that courageous or you want to do. Then I want to be what? Brave. I can do and I will do. Yeah, there might be some aims and ambitions of your in your life. Yeah, have you guys have any ambitions? Yeah, you got that. Optimistic. Optimistic means hoping for good. Hoping for good means feeling good. Yes, feeling good. In here, in the crowd, everyone have a pressure. Everyone have a tensions. That I think someone haven't. Everyone haven't eaten food. Hungry tension. Oh my God. But you have to be happy. Make a cheerful face in your face. So at last, we know. We look at the world, ourselves, and the futures through a negative lens. We generate a negative outcome. What we put out into the world is what we receive. Yes, you put bad things, you get the bad things. And at last, positive thinking leads to the positive experiences and achieve positive outcomes. Thank you.
Sun Jok put everyone at ease through his great speech. Talk on stress management. Of course, it was the importance of positive thinking and its implementation. I'm now calling Miss Resma to tell us something about the importance of social interaction. So Resma, please give her a big hand.
Good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to get this opportunity to speak in front of you all. It's me, Resma Limbu. Importance of social interaction with others. What is social interaction? Social interaction can be defined as the interaction between the people to share their feelings, understanding them and helping them. The one who engages in the social activities that can free from mental and physical pressure. Staying with others make us feel more connected with them. Increase our sense to belong. How can people do interact with others? When people start shake hands with others, when people talk with on phone or enjoying with others. Benefit of social interaction. Meeting new people and making them our friend. Being able to communicate with others. To develop appropriate social skill. It provides many learning opportunities from other people. Feeling good about yourself. At last, every day everyone take part in a SOMS sort of interacting with someone else. Thank you.
So now we have the last speaker. And the topic of her talk is Laughter is the best medicine, and it will be presented by Mallika Oli. So give her a big hand. She's going to tell us something about laughter, which she says is the best medicine.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, everybody. It's me, Mallika Oli, and I'm here to speak about laughter is the best medicine. Sometimes brother make us laugh, right? And we got relief. Yes, laughter is the best medicine to get relief from anger, stress, pain, and everything. So, when do we laugh? When we see or hear something funny, right? When we are at our emotional good. So, let us laugh and stress. We got relief from all the stress. So guys, let us laugh.
Laugh out.
Sometimes we hear people telling that a smiling or laughing person is easily taken advantage of. But I say it is the face that invites friends and happiness. These days we hear about laughter therapy and we tend to laugh at it. I think that is the irony. We do not want to accept what is handed to us in a platter, but we want to create our own and fail at it. Let us be positive and accept the therapy that helps us to get rid of the stress that we always are in. Friends, I know you have been hearing about the stress management, right? Speeches, but you are stressed now, am I right? So let us laugh. 1, 2, 3, go. Let us laugh. How do you feel now? How do you feel now? You feel good? So that's my point. If we laugh, then we will get rid of all the stress, anger, and pain. So laugh loud and live long. Thank you so much.